Good evening and welcome to NewsCenter3 on WTVX, presented on Bethany Cable TV 3 by the Bethany College Department of Communication. I'm Robin Lanyeski.
And I'm Keith Yoseki.
The top stories on tonight's newscast include: Bethany College is closing down for Thanksgiving. What should you do before you leave?
Hurricane Gordon is causing some major damage in the U.S.
And a new report on U.S. smokers is out.
Stay tuned for these stories, plus the weather picture from Marilyn McCloskey, sports highlights by Jamal Robinson, and an interview of Vince Tricu by Derek Gleeman.
This is NewsCenter3 for Wednesday, November 16, 1994. In Bethany News, need a break from studying, working? Well, Thanksgiving break is right around the corner. The Dean of Students Office has released the official Thanksgiving recess schedule. Resident halls will be closed on Saturday at 12 noon and will reopen Sunday, November 27th at 12 noon. Any student who cannot find a ride home and wishes to remain on campus must register with the Dean of Students Office.
The Dean of Students would also like to remind students that the following procedures are to be followed when leaving for Thanksgiving break. Unplug all electrical appliances. Leave cords going, defrost and clean all refrigerators. All trash and perishable food items must be removed from the room. All room windows and doors must remain closed and locked. Finally, students may leave their belongings on campus. However, students are urged to remove all valuables.
Fighting hunger takes more than knowing the facts. This is the message being told by the Campus Ministry Board, who is sponsoring an all-campus fast this Thursday, November 17th. Bethany students who are signing the contract are pledging to not eat in the dining hall all day Thursday. 11 food services have agreed to make a contribution for each student or faculty member who completes the fast. Students and faculty can sign up in the cafeteria during lunch and dinner hours.
You know who is running for SBOG president and vice president? Well, you can find out at the debate that is being sponsored by the Tower. The debate will be held November 30th at 8 p.m. in Render 2. Candidates Brian LeMasters and Tim Picanna will square off against Todd Ollinger and Mandy Allen in a debate that will address the concerns of Bethany students. A Meet the Candidates reception will be held immediately following the debate. The debate will be moderated by Junior Todd Viella.
A soon-to-be former senator has been asked to fill the position of West Virginia Senate Sergeant-at-Arms. Joe Menard says he is willing to accept the position until a news reporter began reporting that he may take the job. The Sergeant-at-Arms is in charge of security in the Senate and Senate offices while it is in session. Menard lost his re-election to the Senate to Rebecca White in the election last week.
The first candidate for governor of West Virginia has thrown his hat into the ring today in Charleston. State Senator Joe Manchin is setting his sights on the seat of Governor Capleton will be leaving in 1996. Manchin says that his primary goal as governor will be to bring more jobs to West Virginia. Manchin won't be alone for long, though. Former State Senator Charlotte Prittis filed pre-candidacy papers, which is a preliminary stage to an official announcement. Senator Ned Jones has also said that he would most likely be a candidate, but he has yet to file the necessary papers. In national news, Central and South Florida are now under a state of emergency due to Tropical Storm Gordon. The storm moved ashore between Fort Myers and Naples. Now it's pushing northeast across the state. Governor Lewis Childs announced in a state of emergency when the storms created tornadoes that killed one person and injured nearly 50 last night. Twisters destroyed at least 50 homes and damaged 100 in one county alone. Crops are also being threatened because of the heavy rain, but estimates on damage have not yet been determined. Gordon is blamed for as many as 4 deaths in Florida and up to 400 in the Caribbean. Well, Marilyn, with the Hurricane Gordon causing so much damage in the U.S., are we going to be seeing any side effects from the storm?
Well, for tonight it's going to be a little cloudy and cold, but for the rest of the week, I don't think we're going to see too much showers. It's going to be pretty warm. So stay tuned for the complete weather picture, but first, take a look at tonight's trivia question. When I was your age, my mama asked me if I wanted to be a secret friend to a family that was out of work and didn't have food money.
Secret friend?
Every week we'd sneak over and eat a stack of groceries on their front porch. And you never found out, and I never told you.
Yeah,
you should be
secret. Yeah.
Come on, secret friend.
Emily Dan, Pastor Warren, your children need them now more than ever. From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Quiet! Make sure we're not wasting water.
Roger.
And last, check that the house is properly insulated. And the best thing, make sure we're recycling all our bottles, cans, and paper.
See, Peggy, what can we do to help the environment?
Let's not waste electricity.
To find out what you can do to help, write to Make a Difference, National Wildlife Federation, Washington, D.C., 20036.
What's up?
Maybe someone's trying to tell you something.
Currently, it is 44 degrees, with the high today at 45 and the low at 42. The wind is set at 11 miles per hour, and the barometer is 30.22. Now to look at our tri-state. In Pittsburgh, it is 43, Washington at 43, Morgantown at 42, Wheeling with the high at 45, and Bethany with 44. Now to look at our highs. We have some 80s down into Florida and some 70s up into Georgia, up into the Great Lakes, some 50s, over into Oregon, some 40s, some 60s into California, and some 60s and 70s into Texas. Now to look at our lows. We have some 70s in Florida, some 40s into the eastern part, some 30s up into the Great Lakes, 20s into the central, and some 50s and 40s over into the west. Now to look at our radar. We have some slight precipitation down into Florida, and also into the east. Now for our satellite. We have a lot of clouds into Florida, moving up into the northern part of the east, and we also have some over in the west, moving over into Oregon. And now for our forecast. Tonight it is partly cloudy, with the low from 30 to 40. So tomorrow, partly cloudy, with the high in the 60s. For tomorrow night, there's a chance of showers with the low in the 40s, the high from 60 to 65. And for Friday, it's going to be fair with the low in the 40s and the high in the 60s.
So the weather's going to be looking pretty good for Thanksgiving break.
Well, hopefully it is.
Okay, thanks, Madeline. The horses may stop running, but the employees are still on the racetrack. 400 employees will be out of work due to voters defeating a measure that would allow video lottery at a thoroughbred racetrack. The employees of the Charleston Town received their termination notices this week. They're not going to take this lying down, though. They have planned a protest march from the track to a county commission meeting in Charlestown. The employees are marching because they want opponents of video lottery to know that they are now without a job. A $10,000 reward is being offered for information leading to the arrest of a suspect in the sexual assault of a 13-year-old newspaper delivery boy. Police say the boy was delivering copies of the Charleston Gazette Saturday morning paper when he was attacked. Charleston Newspapers, which publishes the Charleston Gazette, is offering the reward. Anyone with information is invited to call the newspaper headquarters.
In Pennsylvania News,
A Sarasin woman, once recognized by the Guinness Book of World Records as the world's fattest woman, is suing a supermarket tabloid. Rosalie Bradford claims Star magazine degraded her by comparing her weight to that of a baby elephant in a small car. Bradford, who once made more than 1,000 pounds, has trimmed her weight to just under 300 pounds.
The U.S. is getting close to full diplomatic ties with Vietnam. Senator John Kerry says the only hindrance would be if Vietnam failed to do more than to account for missing American servicemen. Kerry says if Vietnam intensifies its cooperation on the MIA issue, full relations could come next year. He's pushing for documents to be provided about missing servicemen. Kerry doubts that the new Republican majority in Congress will affect the process, since some Republicans also advocate normalized relations with Vietnam.
Haitian government officials say that President Aristide will resign his Roman Catholic priesthood. A Haitian church source says that the Vatican pressured Aristide to step down, and a government source says that Aristide will be complying. Aristide has been at odds with the church leaders over his political stance on behalf of the poor. Although he has gained prominence years ago as an order, he was expelled from the Salesian order in 1988. Aristide has appeared more moderate since his return to Haiti last month after 3 years of exile.
A wide-ranging statement concerning violence and social causes has won approval from Roman Catholic bishops. Leaders of the U.S. Church voted unanimously for a pastoral message on violence, which urges Catholics to work with all faiths to oppose mercy killing, the death penalty, and welfare budget cuts. The message also calls for continued support of gun control and efforts in the anti-abortion cause. The bishop of the nation's largest church says it's time to take these issues out of the realm of attack and into that of highlights concern for the common good. A vote on encouraging and expanding role of women in the church is still pending.
In health news, the number of Americans who smoke cigarettes is lower than it has been since World War II. Federal health officials report that per capita smoking among adults is down to almost 2,500 cigarettes a year, which is about a drop of 1,800 from the peak in 1962. So, Jamal, is there any chance that we might see a win from the trafficking?
Well, at the rate they're going right now, Robin, it certainly looks like they will win this weekend, and I'm sure all the Bethany college students do wish them a lot of luck. And first, his house burned down, and now he's been suspended. We'll find out what else is going to happen with Andre Rison when we come back. But first, let's take a look at tonight's trivia question answer.
School or get medical attention. What's so shocking is these are American children. You can change a child's life with just a phone call and 70 cents a day. By sponsoring an American boy or girl through Christian Children's Fund. Call CCF today and become the most important person in the life of a child, right here in America.
Well, Bethany College soccer team and their coach John Cunningham are geared up and ready to demolish a team from New Jersey this Friday morning. The team, who left the campus less than an hour ago, will travel all night until they reach their destination of Trenton, New Jersey. The Bethany College soccer team is only one game away from the championship. Before leaving today, freshman Sean Posser said, "You guys better watch out because we will return with another win." This is just a reminder to all Bethany students. Classes will be in session on Friday, November 18th. It is only up to the professor of that class as if they want to cancel that class or not. The Chicago Bulls basketball coach has received a $10,000 fine from the NBA. Coach Phil Jackson was given the fine for his unsportsmanlike comments about the referee Hugh Holland's performance in Saturday night's game against Dallas Mavericks. Jackson called Holland's performance brutish and irresponsible. The announcement was made by the league's director of operations, Rod Thorne. The Atlanta Falcons have suspended a key player from this week's game against Denver. Wide receiver Andre Rison has been suspended for repeated violation of team rules. Rison will rejoin the team on Monday's meetings after following the game. The Pittsburgh Steelers once again are plagued with injury problems. Tight end Eric Green is suffering from a sore hamstring, while rookie running back Bam Morris has a painful quadriceps contusion. Both players are listed as doubtful for this Sunday's game against Miami Dolphins. Finally, West Virginia linebacker Matt Tafani says the key to a Mountaineer win this weekend will be to shut down Boston College's running game. Tailback for Boston College, David Green, has 930 yards on 170 carries. That is about more than 5 yards for each attempt. Green's backup, Justice Smith, has 633 yards on 128 carries for about 74 yards a game for more than 5 for each attempt. Coach Don Nealon uses words like monsters and motion to describe Boston's offense. That's all for sports highlights. Back to you, Robin.
Thanks, Jamal, and good luck to the men's bike and soccer team from WCVX. Next on NewsCenter 3, we have a newsmaker interview with Vince Taco right after these messages.
Yeah, so what do we do? I'd like to go.
Well, I'd love to. Now, let's go on out to Canada.
You want to go to what?
Let's go.
I'd really like to.
Well, maybe not.
How about we go?
I want to learn how to make a movie.
I'd like to. Yeah, that sounds like a fun year.
What about
the Girl Scouts?
That's great if you want to make it.
Make sure we're not wasting water.
Gotcha.
And last, check that the house is properly insulated. And the best thing, make sure that we're recycling all our bottles, cans, and paper.
Gee, Piggy, what can we do to help the environment?
Let's not waste electricity.
But to find out what you can do to help, write to Make a Difference, National Wildlife Federation, Washington, D.C., 20036.
Welcome back. Tonight our Newsmaker 3 host is Dirk Swingman, and he talks with Vince Taco.
Hello and welcome to Newsmaker 3. I'm your host, Dirk Swingman. Newsmaker 3 is an interview show featuring Bethany personalities in the news. Newsmaker 3 is produced by students of TV production class. Today's newsmaker is Vince Chaco.
Hi.
Hello, Vince.
Hi, how are you doing?
All right. Vince Chaco is president of the International Student Association, and I know you have a big dinner coming up.
We have a big dinner coming up. It's November 5th. We're going to have, it's called Latin American Night, And that night will feature Latin American food, the menu directly from the Culinary Institute of America. And it'll be prepared probably not by Aladdin workers, probably just by our students in conjunction with Aladdin. The food's going to be very good. It's going to be a very big event. And we expect 500 people in about like 14 different schools.
Can you name a few of them?
Oh, yeah. Kent State University is expected to come up. Pitt University, Carnegie Mellon, Worcester, all the eight East Central Colleges, all the eight East Central Colleges that we play in collegiate sports. And
who are the guests, like teams, international students from other colleges, American students? Or?
Yeah, just international students. We decided to keep it, with international students because the dinner is an international dinner. It's the International Students Association on Bethany. It's a big dinner every year, so we try to bring in as many international students as we can, and just international students pretty much from the other colleges because we already have Americans on our campus that show up.
Mm-hmm. We have some other form of entertainment, music.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Yeah.
What is lined up?
We're going to have a Latin American band come in and play. The band's name is Pernicia, H-E-R-E-N-E-C-I-A, and it's a really 8-member Latin American band. And they're going to come and play for us, and it's going to be very nice. It's going to be a big dance, and we're going to have a very nice time.
So will this dinner be open for everybody? Yeah, every student can attend?
Yes, every Bethany student can attend. It's no problem at all. Just tell them to bring their ID and show up at the door. It's free to Bethany students. Now, we're charging $5 per person that's outside Bethany. So if you don't have a student ID on you, we'll be forced to charge you the $5 fee. But other than that, you're free to come.
Mm-hmm.
And
I want to turn to subject, like the international students just got a new launch.
Oh, yeah.
How is it taken over by the students? Do they enjoy it? Do they need it? Or how is it going with the new launch?
The new international students lounge is located in the bottom floor of Harlan. And now it's called the International Student Center. We are using that place. It's a big lounge. It's really nice. We're using that lounge for study center for international students, a meeting place for our meetings. And we have a computer in there, a Century 610, and a laser writer for our international students to use. If any other student is encouraged to come and join in on meetings, the meetings are Thursday at 7 o'clock in the lounge. And all members are entitled to use the lounge. So it's a great thing to be using, And a lot of students come in, international students come in, relax and take it easy, and have a good time. They have a coffee machine in there, and mm-hmm. sometimes cook in there. It's a lot of fun.
Can you tell us about some activities you do with the International Students Association?
The activities that we like to do during the year vary. They're really interesting. The first activity we normally start out in the year with the international students is it's a retreat. We go to a camp to get them get ready for school, integrated into the United States society. And a lot of international students found that camp very, very helpful.
Which camp is that? And it's organized by the ECC,
East Central Colleges. That's right. That's a little known organization on our campus, but I think more students should know about it. East Central Colleges does a lot of things with all the eight different East Central Colleges in the association. Colleges like Capital and Muskingum and Worcester, and not Worcester, Muskingum and the other colleges, the one in Berea, forgot. Anyway, they do a lot of it with these other colleges. And they bring these other colleges together internationally and culturally and just all the other students together for a nice, youth in our college, And Dennis Landon's the head of that. He's a very nice man, and he helps us with our dinner every year, organizing people to come for our dinner and also telling, getting the word out. And we're also, ECC also sponsors that camp, that's right, and helps out with the other colleges at international students.
Mm-hmm. How are the, as far as I understand, you've got quite a few new international students. How are they adapting to the new environment here in Bethany?
They're adapting very well. We haven't had a failure yet. The 3 years that I've been here, we haven't had a failure with the international students, any of them, yet to date. The international students every year turn out to be very nice people. If you go up and meet them, they're very friendly, and there's no exception this year at all. They're very friendly people, and they're all adapted very well with the help of our advisor, you and Catherine. They did come out very nice.
Mm-hmm. Luke, thank you very much for coming by.
Thank you, Dick.
Thank you very much for joining us. I hope you had a nice time. Yeah, and I hope you will join us at our next show of NewsCenter 3. Bye-bye.
Thanks, Dick. Keith?
Marilyn, how about a weather recap?
Sure. For today, it's going to be partly cloudy with the low from 30 to 40. For tomorrow, it's going to be partly cloudy with the highs in the 60s. For tomorrow night, there's going to be a chance of showers with the low in the 40s and the high from 60 to 65. For Friday, it's going to be fair with the low from 40 to 60. Currently, the high is 45 and the low is 42. Precipitation is set at 0.42 inches. The wind is 11 miles per hour, and the barometer is set at 30.22.
Thanks, Marilyn. Well, that's all for this evening's report. Tonight, we continue our new tradition at NewsCenter 3, Pick Song of the Day, supplied by a member of the NewsCenter 3 crew.
Tonight's selection is provided by my co-anchor, Keith Piasecki. We would also like to congratulate our WTVX Staffer of the Week, anchor Keith Piasecki. Stay tuned for TV3 for more Bethany Select programming this evening. At 6 o'clock, the Bethany Video Network. At 7 o'clock, a retelecast of NewsCenter 3. And at 7:30, continuing coverage of the third round of NCAA Soccer Championship with Bethany versus University of California. From everyone at WCBS, thanks for watching and have a great evening.
All the best of luck. And that's all for me. I'll see you on Thursday. Bye-bye. I'm scared.
Located on Main Street in Bethany, is a proud supporter of Bethany College and WVBC. College Inn is your lottery agent in Bethany. The College Inn is open 7 days a week and features video rentals, beverages, and a variety of snack foods. A convenient store for the family is College Inn Beer and Grocery. Hey, how you doing? It's about 7 o'clock on the nose. I'm Aaron. I'll be with you through the next hour. 41 degrees outside, and you're tuned in to WVBC 88.1 in Bethany, the Ohio Valley's only alternative. For the break, you just heard some Blind Melon.